Eric Julien is at it again. Hi, Eric. He is predicting that there will be a UFO event in London, England, April 4th. And this is the beginning of actual serious coming out of the ETs here on this planet. So this video will talk about various and sundry things. We'll just have a chat about all of this. This is the Eric Julien, of course, of Divine Strike. The comet was it Wasserman, Schumann, or whatever you call it, P73. That supposedly a fragment was going to come off and go into the Atlantic Ocean, cause a massive tsunami, and cause worldwide panic. From this, it didn't happen, but supposedly it was a warning to the U.S. to not launch a preemptive nuclear strike against Iran, which they didn't do. And it supposedly postponed a huge bomb test called Divine Strike or something in Nevada, I think, a conventional bomb. But apparently, the ETs were concerned about a nuclear war, and they didn't want it to happen. They threatened the world. And I guess he says a successful. So he's a contactee. Eric Julien's a contactee from France. And he's a lifelong contactee. And I would say he's a legitimate contactee because his book, The Science of the Extraterrestrials, something along that lines of that title, is one of the most sophisticated books you'll ever read about the science of the extraterrestrials. So he's a super, super, super pro ET-er. He says that they're good ETs and they're here to save us from destroying the Earth and the bad ETs. And who are the bad ETs? There's all sorts of talk about, who are the bad ETs, etc. And some say from the Orion, Belt of Orion, from the Orion star system, the Betelgeuse, the Greys from Betelgeuse, and interesting, the Belt of Orion, the three stars. You notice the trident of the Ukraine, the three star, the trident, the double trident on the Malaysian plane that disappeared. The trident at the World Trade Center, the tridents there, the trident of the comet Ison, and the Orions are supposedly the bad guys who stirring up conflict in this world. Okay, so it's supposedly everything is supposed to come to a head very soon. The Queen Elizabeth is visiting Pope Francis today, Thursday, and it's very interesting that apparently England has had just a massive flurry of advertisements featuring extraterrestrials. That started in the 2012 Olympics in London, actually. If you looked at the way they publicized it, was the theme was all these flying saucers, actually these funny little cuddly beings and these little flying saucers flying everywhere. It was all about popularizing flying saucers, getting people used to the notion. Now Eric Julien says that there will be a flyover on April 4th, that his contacts told him that this is planned and there is a blueprint to roll out contact now. And we'll see. He's certainly is a contactee, in my opinion, and so we'll see if his information is right. Of course, no information that any contactee has ever gotten has actually ever been true in terms of, like, public, that there's going to be a big public push, disclosure, ETs are going to show up in the skies, all that stuff. As far as I know, it's never happened. So this might have a 0% possibility of happening, or it might happen, because you cannot ignore various other signs that are occurring. There's definitely an attempt to familiarize the world with extraterrestrials. This has been going on for a long time, since they showed up, supposedly, but around the end of World War II, when atomic energy was brought to bear in this world, came about, they showed up, and ever since then there has been a gradual rollout to kind of hybridize Earth civilization and ET civilization, and There's no question that has happened. There's no question that they've shared their technology. There's no question that they have turned the planet towards their comfort zone, of the way they want things to be. So it's very likely at some point we will have begin to have close encounters, and there's a hybridization program that's been taking place for a long time. All this stuff is very well known to those who've been researched it. But what Julian says is there's going to be a unmistakable huge event in London on April 4th, where in the sky you will see the UFO ships, and there'll be people contacted, telepathically contacted at that time, etc., etc., etc. So, what is the take on this that I have to share? The main thing that I have to share, first of all, Julian is, again, totally pro-ET. He says that they're here to help us, give us bodies of light, and to help us ascend into higher dimensions and fix the world, free energy, global ecosystem, all this kind of stuff. So he's super, super, super pro, thinks that they're the answer. Now, there is absolutely nothing that I've ever seen from extraterrestrials in a lifetime of research and study that would indicate that they know anything about salvation, actually. They really don't know. They really don't know. They're just as ignorant as you and I. So, ultimately, my response to ETs is just to ignore them. It's a non-story, it's a non-issue. But it may become the issue of 214. There's a British scientist who just published a book, I believe, today, saying that in 2014 there is going to be the event which sets the course for the 21st century, and it will be an astonishing event for the whole world. And it could very well be we become aware of extraterrestrials. Now, President Bill Clinton, again, I said in the previous video, was on that Jimmy something show, Fallon, where he was pressed on this whole extraterrestrial thing. It was all set up. I mean, it was all scripted. He knew what was coming, and he spilled the beans, but he has some very hot statements about him, about how it's going to cause world peace by everybody feeling there's an alien invasion threat. Well, that's Project Blue Beam is a false alien invasion which causes the world to unite, which, of course, a false alien invasion could easily be staged by craft that the shadow world government has actually manufactured. And so people will think they're aliens, but they're really not. They're from this world. That's possible too. But certainly, there are extraterrestrials who have their own craft. And Julian says, okay, they're going to make themselves shown. We're here. And that England is being prepped for it. Well, that is very possible because England is by far and away the country that is most aligned with the extraterrestrials. They have been for a long time. That is where the most work on genetics and mutations and gene splicing and all the sort of stuff where, like, the rest of the world either doesn't have the sophistication or has laws against that. I mean, they're into cloning. They're just cloning everything. They seem to not be bothered by any sort of scientific endeavor, as if scientific endeavor has its own inherent morality to it. They don't have to worry about any of that stuff. So they are, in my opinion, Great Britain is the place most likely to have contact take place. And London, of course, is the head of the new world government, new world order, the world banking. London is where it's at. London has long been connected with this Illuminati New World Order and in extraterrestrials contact, etc. So if they're going to show up, that's probably where they would show up, over London. So that makes sense. Well, so I would say the best thing to do with ETs is to ignore the story, but it may not be ignorable, because it may keep snowballing. Julian says there's going to be a series of sightings, and one after the other, and the whole thing is going to snowball to rolling out this whole new world order, and so it may not be possible to avoid it. But from a spiritual standpoint, they don't have anything to offer, actually. Nothing. Nothing I've ever studied. I've studied an enormous amount about ETs. I've never seen they have anything to offer. It's all relativism. It's all relativism. It's all relativism. There's no genuine spiritual teaching there at all. And even though many, many people go for this, etc. Now, if you want to see, real spiritual teaching, you go to the heavyweights that have helped humanity out here on this planet. And once you're familiar with that, then you realize that the ETs are just lost in space. They're very much lost in space. And they don't have anything to offer those who are already well-versed and on the path to salvation. We already know what the path is. We already know what the goal is. We've already had our great teachers. So we don't really need the ETs to tell us anything about that. And yet they're very sure of themselves, that they have a lot to tell us. And so they will be very adamant. They're very great with their rhetoric, etc. So it's a big problem. The ET situation is a huge, huge problem. But it's happening. It's coming. Whether Julian's right or not, this time, maybe he'll be right this time. He claims he was right last time, and people will argue that. But he is saying it's going to happen. So it's somebody, the contactee, is making this declaration. It's going to happen. Watch, it's going to happen. So if it does happen. And even if it doesn't happen, the conditioning of the world is going in that direction without the slightest bit of doubt to that. It is going in that direction, has been going in that direction for quite some time. And it's inevitable that we will get caught up in this whole 21st century is all about, contact. Contact with ETs. It's all about that. It's all about hybridizing the civilizations. It's all about bringing hybrid people, hybrids between different races. It's all about that stuff, which I have to say does not interest me in the slightest bit. I could absolutely care less about it. None of that stuff interests me, actually. It's a non-story because it's the same old, same old. Same old, same old. There's no real meaning or importance to it whatsoever. None. None of the stuff they bring has any real importance. No value. There's no value to it. There's no value to the ETs, even though they will appear as white knights. There's no value to them. We're better off just being, just things going as they are, and people focusing on the vision of oneness, which is our salvation, actually. Now, I liken the vision of oneness to the following scenario. I view the world, the universe, as one vast garbage dump through the body's perception, okay, without the vision of oneness. Now, the vision of oneness overlaying the universe, the whole thing feels like a beautiful, beautiful park, the whole thing, okay. But as far as without that, which is what we're projecting, it's one huge garbage dump. That's all it is. No meaning, no value to it whatsoever, nothing. But it's our garbage dump. So we're used to living in a garbage dump. So what the Holy Spirit does is it overlays this garbage dump with this beautiful light, this beautiful, lovely, living light of remembrance. And then the garbage dump, everything looks, reminds us of reality. It says, oh my gosh, I remember my true home. This is not my true home. This garbage dump is not my true home. I remember my true home. So it's the light that reminds us. It's not the garbage that reminds us. But because we're so used to the garbage, we have this severe continuity problem. And by the way, not only do all humans have the exact same problem, which is the continuity problem, all extraterrestrials have the exact same problem too, which is the continuity problem. So they have the exact same problem. Everyone has the exact same problem. It doesn't matter if they're from Orion, Sirius, whether they're you know, the Greys, the Nordics, the Reptilians, well, you name it, all the different types. It doesn't matter. They also have just one problem, and that's the continuity problem. So, same old, same old, same old. There's nothing there. It's not like we need to hang around and study the ETs. No, there's no reason to study ETs at all. And by the way, because they have the exact same problem as everyone. There's only one problem. It's the continuity problem that's already been studied. It's already been brought to light. Exercises and how to resolve this already been here. And the vision of oneness is already present there as the goal for everyone. ETs, humans, you name it. It's all the same. So there's no reason to study their culture in the slightest bit. You gain nothing from that. Just a waste of time. Now, speaking of that, I say something. Don't go to the island of Dr. Moreau. Don't go to the island of Dr. Moreau. Do not go to those tropical islands. Do not go to those islands scattered throughout the vast stretches of the ocean where, supposedly, what their plan is, in my opinion, is to lure people to those islands who are very spiritually advanced with the opportunity to interact with some sensitive, highly sensitive ETs and to teach them the spirituality of this planet. They have all these cover stories of saying here's a great opportunity for the most advanced people of this planet, spiritually advanced, to interact with the ETs away from humanity, where you'll be able to come in contact and live with them in like spiritual retreats and help teach them, you know, school them in the spiritual teaching of this planet so they'll be able to better relate to the world and better rule this planet more successfully. In other words, help them establish a new one-world religion. You remember in World War II where the Nazis had these camps of medical experimentation, right? They took prisoners and they took doctors, Dr. Mengele or something. Yeah. That's what these islands are really about. They're really places to experiment on the spiritually advanced people of this planet, to try and convert them to the extraterrestrials' way of belief system. They want to carry out all sorts of experimentations, you know, terrible stuff, and they want to figure out, you know, they want to study these people. Do all sorts of modification, gene splicing, modification, just whatever, you know, all their technology, and try to change them and convert them to their belief system. Ultimately, they want those people to die there too if they cannot convert them properly. So there's no law there at all on these very remote islands where they'll set this up. So they can conduct any experiments they want to, medical, genetic, waveform, interfering with your brain, you're trying to change your spirit, your beliefs in the most terrible ways. That is what they have planned. So there's no law out there in those planets at all. They can just simply do whatever they want with no repercussions. You disappear, never heard from again, and that's the end of it. So whatever you do, do not go to those remote tropical islands, remote islands, any place on this planet. That is for sure. Don't go to the island of Dr. Moreau, the crazy lunatic experimenter who wants to conduct all these experiments on you. And there's also other things that they do there, which I don't need to get into. They're too terrible to talk about. But the cover story also is that there's some great spiritual masters, their ashrams are on these planets and these islands, and you can go there and work with them. And there's a program to help ETs and humanity interact, and your special role to play in that. They know how to flatter you, your spiritual ego, to an unbelievable extent. Don't believe in any of that stuff. Very, very important. They're great deceivers, the ETs. They're very used to throwing out cover stories for what their real intentions are. And to them, that's just the way things are. That's how they think. Is what kind of, how can I market and advertise what I'm doing so people will be simply are great marketers and advertisers to sell their product and get buyers for their product. They'll say that, you know, they need telepaths to go there and they can telepathically interact with the ETs and on and on and on and on. And you'll think, wow, I'm a really special person. I'm a very important person if I go there. Now you're going there. They want to study you. They want to dissect you. They want to find out, you know, why do you think the way you do? And they want to figure out a way to change you, to accept them the way they are and to believe that their beliefs are correct, etc. So the universal truth is that we all have a severe continuity problem. That's a universal truth. Anyone who says they're in the appearance, external appearance, this appearance, like a body form, has a severe continuity problem. Absolutely. Has a severe continuity problem. Unless they happen to be awakened and profess their awakening and give clear-cut evidence that they are awakened and they realize that this form is just an external appearance and is not their identity at all. The great teachers, the great avatars. Everyone else has a severe continuity problem. Extraordinary deluded. They're dealing with projections. We're only dealing with our projections. Everything is just a projection of our mind, thinking that it's outside of the mind. Okay, and that appearances are interacting with other appearances, each one external to the other. This is all total delusion. And we've been so enmeshed in delusion that we all have this incredibly severe continuity problem that's unrecognized, and we're desperately defending against waking up from our coma because we think it would cause an abrupt change of experience and we lose our identity forever and we wouldn't know who we are, and we're terrified of it. That is why we keep staying very, very busy with all these blueprints of taking over planets, traveling to other planets, you know, changing society, social engineering, this, and that. All to keep our attention off of this continuity issue, all to keep us from solving it, because it's very easily solvable. Super easy, super simple. You just accept the overlay, vision of oneness, God's lovely light of remembrance, touching everything equally. The whole garbage dump, all at the same time, equally. And nothing has to happen in the garbage dump, right? It doesn't matter. All the flies and the seagulls and the worms and the maggots and the stench and it, everything. It doesn't make the slightest difference what there is in this garbage dump. It's all equally overlaid. And it's not the garbage dump that's reminding us of reality. It's the overlay of it that reminds us of reality. So we still have the garbage dumps there. We say, oh, it's still there, but now it's overlaid by this living light, a lovely light of remembrance, and this is what I'm paying attention to. This is what's reminding me of reality. Okay, so very, very simple, isn't it? That's the vision of oneness, the vision of one. Everything is one. Everything is equally touched by this presence of oneness. Equally touched, the whole universe. That reminds us of reality. Continuity problem solved. That's it. That's all the teachers are telling us. This whole ET thing about they're going to teach us right morality and that you advance through doing good works and all that stuff, that's all total delusion, actually. That's what doesn't work. That's what keeps you on this endless treadmill, avoiding the vision of oneness, really. Vision of oneness overlays everything right now as it is. Every bad act, good act, evil thought, good thought, every emotion, it's all a pile of garbage anyway. It's all relative. Relativeness is just a garbage dump. A garbage dump of judgment, of really nothingness, of meaninglessness. It's all meaningless. It's all valueless. It's all garbage. Everything here is falling apart anyway, right? Everything that arises, every appearance that arises is also going to fall apart. So it's meaningless, so it's just equally overlaid. What else can God do except that say it's all equally meaningless? It is. It's all equally meaningless. Yet, we're desperately trying to seek meaning in it so that we don't wake up from the coma. So we say, no, I got to learn how to be a good person. The ETs are going to help me. They're going to school me. I'll be able to get the right information from the ETs. They don't have any information to give us, actually, that's valuable. What else could they say except, hey, you know, you got a severe continuity problem, the vision of oneness solves it, let's focus in on the spiritual practices, and that's it. There isn't any anything else to say. There isn't anything else to say, actually. But they never say that. They say, no, we're here to school you in a million different ways of how to rearrange all the garbage here, how to work with the garbage, how to sculpt the garbage, how to channel the garbage, how to shred the garbage, how to build up more garbage, how to paint the garbage, how to perfume it, how to eat the garbage, how to throw it away. And just 1 minute. Endless, 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 endless involvement with meaningless, valueless garbage. Same old, same old, same old. I don't care if somebody comes from Orion, Sirius, or the Pleiades, or wherever, it doesn't matter. It's all one big universe of garbage, meaningless, valueless garbage, relativism, just appearances, everything appearing as imagination within the mind, as an attempt to believe that it's possible that they can have a separate creation. Possible to undo creation, possible to change reality. The reality isn't what it is. It's spiritual pride, spiritual self-deception. And of course they'll say, they always say they're teaching oneness. How can you teach oneness? That's the craziest thing ever. Teaching oneness, meaning you need to do good to one another, and you'll see that one's good, I'm good, you're good, that one's good, everyone's gonna be good. That's not salvation. Salvation is this moment, this very moment, just as everything is right now. There's absolutely no specialness in the universe. I see a specialness for a universe this very instant, without anything changing in the slightest bit. Everything is one, overlaid. Everything is one. We see the oneness resting upon everything, without exception. That is oneness. Oneness comes from God. Oneness, it doesn't come from moral or ethical behavior. It doesn't come from structuring a nice civilization, not having nice parties, nice intellectual chit-chat, human kindness. No, that has zero to do with salvation. Nothing. Salvation doesn't come from works. It comes from the grace of God entirely. Entirely. Works have absolutely nothing to do with it. They're just delaying tactics. They're just delaying tactics. That's all they are. You ask the great sages, you know, hey, how can we make the world a better place? What? You say, what? It's already absolutely perfect. Everything as it is totally perfect. That is the vision of oneness. That's a true sage who doesn't have the slightest inclination to change anything here. Because they know what salvation is. Salvation is the remembrance of reality as reality is, and reality is completely perfect and flawless, right? Always. So it has to be right now. We can't be reminded of reality by any process at all. Any process at all is self-deception, is delusion, is meaningless. It has no value in reminding us of reality whatsoever. So the ETs don't teach this. They don't teach this. So they're useless. They're useless. And we have to, since I believe they're certainly, the way things are going, they're so interwoven now in our culture through popular media and entertainment, etc. And their attitudes have been interwoven, and people are trying to mimic them. It's been going on for a long time, actually, mimicry of the ETs. That we can't just, you know, say that, well, they don't exist, that doesn't work. But we do have to just be humorous about it. Be humorous, you know. Good little ETs don't have anything else to offer. Treat them like little children, like they really are, which means that they're ignorant. They're ignorant. Don't deify them. Don't be in awe. Don't, you know, act like this is really something heavy. No, it's nothing. Much ado. Little children running around. Little cartoon characters. There's nothing important about ETs whatsoever. Absolutely nothing. So you have to laugh about it, chuckle about it, and maintain a sense of humor, and realize that those who are on the spiritual path are the properly oriented, properly responsible. Those who are not yet responsible. They're irresponsible, like children, very irresponsible. And again, cannot allow your psyche to put importance on them. Do not put importance on them. So that is, you know, all important. You want to stop short of mocking them. We don't want to mock them, but we want to look at them with the grins and the laughs, being in the know about, here they go again, you know, here he goes again. The little ET's showing up again, the same old nonsense. You know, oh boy, when are they ever going to learn, you know? And it just like the bothersome, you know, little kid that just, you know, they got their hand in the cookie jar again. And look at them that way, as like children who have yet to grow up. And of course, but they're very self-important. ETs are very self-important. If they had their way, they would eliminate anybody who doesn't take them seriously, for sure. They have a sort of an extreme desire, a demand that they be taken seriously, because of course they're irresponsible. So what else can they do? Say, you know, they're worried. Like, I hope the people here take us seriously. You know, and no, we don't take you seriously, ETs, not at all, because you're not talking what's really serious and important. You're irresponsible. Doesn't matter what kind of ships you fly in or whatever, you're still irresponsible. What, you think we get in an airliner and we fly somewhere that makes us responsible? Oh, I flew on an airplane, it means I'm responsible. No, it has nothing to do with it. You think we have a smartphone, we'd be suddenly, oh, I'm a responsible, spiritually responsible person, I have a smartphone. No, that's what the advertisements tell us. So they think that we can purchase spiritual responsibility somehow. I just have the right gadgets and do the right things, I'm spiritually responsible. So. Of course you can't take that seriously. If you forget to laugh at that, you're in big trouble. Jesus always says, don't forget to laugh at all these appearances, all this imagination, all this delusion. Don't forget to laugh at a crazy idea trying to replace God. Have a good laugh at it. It's quite funny. It's quite funny, actually. In a certain way. So we will continue to, you know, just not deny what's taking place, etc., but just not interested, and not really worthy of much attention at all. Not worthy of much attention, just like all the news stories in the world, not really worthy of attention. And, you know, little children running around playing, and you say, you notice little kids are playing, you know, like on a playground, school playground, and you got more important stuff to do. You don't sit there transfixed by, oh, look at the kids, they're playing. No, let the kids play, and you get about your business. That's how I look at it. So whatever the ETs are going to do here, I don't care, it's not important, it's not relevant. Now, of course, they may cause all sorts of troubles, foment troubles, and so there may be ramifications of it, that is for sure. Now, one of the tactics the ETs use, I say don't go to the island of Dr. Moreau. Be careful of the good cop, bad cop sort of thing. This is one of their favorite games, is they will say, we're taking you again to a re-education center. You need to get with the program. And you're so freaked out by this, and then along comes someone else going in the opposite direction and like a savior to you. You say, oh my God, I'll go with them. And the ETs and the first people say, wow, you're escaping our clutches. You're going to freedom. We hate this. We hate you. How dare you do this? They're so angry. And you think, oh, I made the great right choice. No, that other person going the opposite direction, supposedly, is in cahoots with the first. They're playing good cop, bad cop. And they're really getting you to that island. They want to get you to that island where you disappear from the world and they can conduct all their experiments upon you to try to figure out, why are you so crazy? You've got to be able to cure this craziness. See, they're afraid of humanity because they think humanity is crazy. It's got this crazy religious thing, you know, like they believe in God. You know, they believe in salvation. They believe in Christ. You know, they believe in... And They say, we got to figure out how to get rid of this. You know, let's get the people who really are, you know, really strongly believe this, and let's get them on an island. They may have a whole bunch of islands where they take different type of prisoners and stuff. They don't call them prisoners. They'll dress it up and say, you know, people who are, you know, working with us to figure out how we can acculturate and live together as one or something. And they'll do all the experiments trying to figure out how to change your belief, thought, structure, and all this kind of stuff. So just because someone rescues you from one group doesn't mean that they themselves are not a bad apple too. The two groups could be in cahoots with one another. I think this is the ETs, one of their favorite little programs. And the whole operation is designed to you to go with the second group to a place where you really don't want to go to. It's even worse than the first place. But by escaping the first bad option, you don't appropriately evaluate the second bad option. You just, all you're thinking of is, oh, I'm so relieved I escaped the first option, not even thinking about how terrible the second option is. So this is something that you have to be aware of. Now, there's going to be so much going on in the world soon that we can't possibly cover it all. We don't want to. It's a waste of time. What's important is to just stay centered in the confession that I have a severe continuity problem. Everyone has the exact same problem. We only have one problem, one universal problem, in the realm of appearances is the continuity problem. As Longchenpa, the great radical Dzogchen Tibetan master, said, that everybody's fear really is that if they let go of delusion, they'll fall into an abyss. He's talking about the continuity problem. And he said that is the one problem that everyone has. Exactly right. Exactly right. It's just a way of saying it, to fall into the abyss. We think, yeah, without all these appearances, these temporary appearances, you know, there'll be nothing. We'll fall into an abyss or something. Without our imagination deceiving itself, we will fall into an abyss. And so it's the same. We all have exactly one problem, a continuity problem. Stay centered in that. And this moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This moment, this universe as it is, this very moment as it is totally free of all specialness. Stay with those practices. It keeps you centered, it protects you from all these games the ETs are playing and will be playing in this world. They're already playing so many here. And of course, human nature plays a lot of games too. ETs are just a little more sophisticated. And have seemed to have less of a conscience about it all. That's for sure. Have to stay centered in that. Have to stay centered in continuity practice. That's why I was pressured by the Holy Spirit to produce all these videos about continuity practice for the world prior to some event that's coming up. So the Holy Spirit knows something's coming up that is really going to cause a lot of people to lose their focus, to say, what do I do, what do I do, what do I do? Well, I want to be able to say, look, here's the continuity practice. Here's some videos. Here's a way to recenter yourself. You have to stay centered. I just recently put two videos on. 1 minute, please. All right. Well, to pick up the thread, I'm not sure where I left off, but we have to stay centered. It doesn't make you special to hang out with an ET. We're not after specialness. We're after the vision of oneness, vision of non-specialness. This whole ET thing is going to bring this mania of specialness, like who gets to associate with them, you know, who's contactees, you know, who gets to, maybe some people have been, you know, some spiritual teachers, ET teachers are teaching them some new spirituality that are special. That's what we want to get to stay away from. We want to see the vision of non-specialness. We want to pray to the Holy Spirit, which represents the non-projected will, your will in a non-projected condition. Everything we're seeing in the universe is a projection of our will, okay? Attempt to project our will as a separate will. And that projection is playing, is doing all the playing, okay? It's not a separate will, it's a projected and disassociated and denied will, disassociated will, and it's the one that's causing all this stuff to happen. Now, the Holy Spirit represents our true unprojected will, our unprojected will. We don't want to do that anymore, but we're scared. We think we need to unify. There's two separate wills. We need to unify separate wills, blend separate wills, blend ETs and humans, blend, hybridize, splice, mutate, gene, you know, all this stuff. No, we don't need to do any of that stuff. So pray to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is within us. It represents, it knows our unprojected will. It knows our true will. It knows our will in the way God created it. And it speaks for that will and helps us get back to that, to drop our projections, So the real teacher is the Holy Spirit. The real teacher is the Holy Spirit, is the grace of God. Different traditions use different terms for it, right? Of course. So we're not trying to push the Judeo-Christian terminology on anybody. It's just, but it's a common parlance to say that. The Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wholeness is a way of putting it. It's a pragmatic term. The Spirit of whole will, holiness, means one unprojected will. It is that which knows and is the advocate for our unprojected will. We pray to that to show us the vision of non-specialness. Show us the vision of non-specialness, Holy Spirit. That is all we need. And at this time when contact is likely to take place, 2:14 is likely. It wouldn't surprise me, as Bill Clinton said, it wouldn't surprise me in the slightest bit if it happens, right? He said getting the world ready for it. And by the way, me and Mr. William Jefferson Clinton share the same birthday. So we're saying the same thing today, is prepare for contact. Definitely wouldn't be surprised at all if it happened in 2:14. And just as non-special, we're seeing the vision of non-specialness. We have to be grounded in the vision of non-specialness. There's nothing special. Now the ETs think they're very special, and the world will think they're very special. It's going to be a mania personality of specialness in the world. And we're already there. The world, I just look at some of these advertisements around the world and what people are producing. I was researching this a little bit. And it's just, you know, I have to just laugh. That's all I can do. So pathetic, you have to laugh. So utterly caught up in the cult of personality, of projections, of the human animal, of the antics, and the, you know, how it just, you know, if you're a serious spirit mind, you just dismiss that as completely meaningless garbage and no value whatsoever, and just instantly no value to that at all. A complete waste of time. All the movies, all the music, everything that's coming out in the modern world now is, to me, is just utterly valueless. So we turn to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, that represents the non-projected will, guide us back. Guide us into the solution of the continuity issue we have, where we can accept that our will has not been broken, has not been split, has not been separated. It's just been disassociated. And help me heal this disassociation, heal our perception. Perception, see, the insanity of the ETs and of the world is that they think they can bring about peace in the world, where the fact is that it's perception itself that is the problem. It is sensory perception that is the problem. And it comes from projection, which comes from our desire to displace God, and a projection of will that results in what's called the perception, which results in what's called personality belief in the personality as a self, which is just all these judgments of perception, actually. It's impossible to have peace as long as you are perceiving. Sensory perception is how you're trying to get meaning. Okay, it's impossible. You will judge. You will feel fearful of others, because what is nearer to you will seem more familiar than what is farther away from you, and it is completely impossible. So they're just barking up the wrong tree entirely. Just barking up the wrong tree with all their genetic stuff is just total nonsense. You have to have healed perception, which is vision of non-specialness, oneness, non-specialness. vision of non-specialness is what the Holy Spirit has for us. And we may think, oh my God, I don't want to do that because I won't be special. Well, nothing is special. That's what we really want to see. I guarantee you, it's what we really want to see. And of course, we all delay. I delay, you delay, we all delay. But in the glimpses I've had of it, this is what I really want. I know it's what you really want. You'd be absolutely amazed when the vision of non-specialness, the vision of oneness, the vision of non-specialness, you feel like, oh my gosh, this reminds me of home. I'm remembering my home. Oh, I'm waking up from my coma. I've been in a coma. You're like, wow, this is great. And specialness is a total anathema to our spirit. Total anathema. Totally. But inherently arises from perception. Specialness inherently arises from perception, which inherently arises from projection. Inherently so. So these don't have any real answers for us. We already have the answers. So again, when someone comes up and pretends like they have the answer for you and you already know the answer, you know, what you can do but laugh. Laugh them off and go off and play. Don't bother me. You know, that kind of thing. You have to take a humorous response to it. And of course, someone who has good humor, etc., is someone who's very confident and very centered and very grounded. You look at these CEOs of big corporations, these very wealthy people, they're always very smiling and humorous and self-deprecating or anything, because they say, oh, we're top dogs, and they can feel that way. You're very confident. You can laugh at yourself, laugh at everything, and it feels very light and humorous and all. And so that's the attitude they have towards the ETs. Is, oh, okay, ET, you're here. Okay, well, you know, you might as well get back on your horse and go back to where you came from, because we don't really need you here. And it's wasting your time. Don't want to waste your time. And, you know, give them a little spiritual truth. Hey, ETs, I don't want you to keep wasting your time. You know, you spend probably, how long did you spend, ET, actually blueprinting this whole takeover of the planet? I mean, wow, it must have taken you a long, thousands and thousands of years. You've probably been working on this. What a waste of time. That's a terrible waste of time. What a shame, you know. I don't want you to waste any more time. You know, you better get down to really, you know, I hope you learned this lesson, E.T. I hope you learned the lesson this time, finally, that it's just a waste of time to do all this stuff. You know, just a waste of time. So don't keep wasting your time. Let's get down to continuity practice, you know. Be quiet, sit down, and start practicing. Like that, just like that. They just have this, you know, okay, business as usual. Everybody, some people don't want to practice, some do. Those who do, get down, let's practice. That's all. Nothing is as simple as that. As simple as that. You know, here comes some different juvenile delinquents, you know, basically. Now, it might not be a good idea, though, to actually engage them, because they're on an ego trip. You know, they can be on a very severe ego trip of thinking that they're here with all the answers for us, and those who don't accept the answers are very bad. They're blocking the agenda or something. So there was this, I may have said this in another video, there's this homeless person that was just completely wacko. Unfortunately, ranting and raving and gesturing wildly and walking along just out of his mind, you know. And I happened to be walking there with my back turned out of a store, and I heard this, and I said, "This, I don't like the way this sounds, you know. I'm going to go to my car." And I'd just been thinking about how maybe it'd be interesting to talk to these homeless people ranting and raving. I said, maybe they have something to tell the world. Maybe something important to tell the world. And somehow my personality, even picking up that I'm supposed to take video of these people, maybe they're just, nobody's listening to them, it's driven them crazy. But my response to this person was, no. Get in the car, lock the doors, stay in the safety of the car, stay inside. In other words, don't interact with this person. They're out of control lunatics. Lunatic. So that's what I did. So my response to the ETs is, don't interact with them. Don't interact with them. They're out of control lunatics, really. They are not receptive to the simple truth of non-perfect non-specialness. They're not receptive to it. They may think that they are. They don't have any great message for humanity, is another thing. So there's no need to interact with them. There is no great message coming up at all. Nothing historic at all taking place. The truth is that we all have the exact same problem, which is the continuity problem. That's already been declared here. In the Judeo-Christian tradition, we all have our sinners missing the mark. It's a continuity problem. We all have a continuity problem. Fear of the abyss, as Longchenpa said. And we already know what the answer is, which is the vision of oneness. So it's just a matter of getting down to work and a soft landing into the vision of oneness. There's nothing special. There's no historic announcement to be made. Same old, same old, same old. Nothing changes, actually, about this situation. Perception breeds self-delusion, severe self-delusion, a severe continuity problem. And so we just have to get to work on this. Practice, 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 practice. Same old, same old, same old. Nothing new under the sun in the universe. There is nothing new under the sun in the entire universe, okay? Absolutely nothing. Just one problem and one solution to it. That's it. And the various ways that we turn our attention to it or delay. And the formats that delay can take are infinite. So you have this infinite dance of appearance, dancing. It's just all delay. It's just all delay. And there's nothing new about that. So there's nothing new under the sun, or under any sun at all. So, you know, the ETs show up and they say, okay, sit down. Classes and sessions, sit down, be quiet and steady. There's nothing new they have to say to us at all. Of course, there'll be free energy and ways to clean up, heal the ecosystem, and all the people will just be completely head over heels with idolatry, etc. But from our standpoint, it's all a garbage dump. It is all mere appearance. And the only problem we have is a continuity problem. And so it's just the same old, same old, same old, same old. If you were to go visit Longchenpa in Tibet back in the day, was it the 14th century, something like that? And you walked into his monastery. I think it was the top monastery there. I can't remember the name of it. And he was giving meditation or giving a talk, and you came from like the 20th century, and you had your iPod, and you had your smartphone. Or I guess all smartphones all in one, basic thing. You got your ear things on, and maybe your Google glasses, and you're calibrating your GPS and all, and you're all teched out, and you just think like you're so cool. You arrive on a jet, and you got all this, you're totally modern, and you're all got your piercings and your tattoos and your dyed hair and just the whole nine yards of whatever it is that's taking place here, listening to your electronic dance trance music. And you walked into the monastery back in the 14th century, and Longchenpa's there. Longchenpa would, bow to you and please sit down and just continue on teaching, and just as before. No, nothing historic, nothing unusual, nothing out of the ordinary, nothing has taken place at all. It's the same situation. Someone from the future arrives here, it's nothing. It's the same old, same old. It doesn't matter where they arrive from, whether it's a million years in the future, a million years in the past, or whatever. Same problem, same solution. Just practice right now, right here, right now. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. This spot, along with every other spot, is totally bathed in the lovely light of lovely living light of God's remembrance. This person, along with every other person, is totally graced by God's lovely light of a living light of remembrance. This tree, along with all other things, all other objects, all other appearances, is totally graced by the lovely living light of God's remembrance. You practice, practice, practice. Nothing historic. Somebody walks into my future, it's not historic at all. There's nothing. The time doesn't really matter. The future doesn't matter. The future doesn't matter. The future is always now. The past is always now. It's all just now. Same problem, same solution. So what do we need a past or a future for, actually? There's no reason for it. Not really. Vision of oneness covers everything. Always. So, there's always non-total, non-specialness. Whether it's the past or the future. The future would be totally non-special too. The past has been totally non-special. The present is totally non-special. What need do we have for time then, for the fat past and the future? We don't need it, right? By the way, if the ETs say, oh, that I am on one of these islands, I'm teaching there, don't believe them. Don't believe them. Don't believe them. Don't go there. They'll use that trick, say there's a bunch of teachers that have gone there. Maybe some do go there. Oh, you get to see such and such. They're there. They're teaching on a retreat in one of these islands. Don't believe them. Don't believe them. That's good advice, because you can do these practices right where you are. In fact, it's all important you do them where you are. Right here, where I am, right now, the entire universe is totally free of all specialness. The entire past is totally free of all specialness. And the entire future is totally free of all specialness. Right here, right now, where I am, this moment, this place, without moving at all, without changing, without an instant passing, this is true. So it's all about practicing where you are, where you are. Right here, right now, practicing right here, right now, where I am. If you see an ET, say, ah, this ET, along with everyone else in the world, ETs, non-humans, whatever, every, along with them, oh, I see that the grace of God's lovely, beautiful, living light of non-special remembrance is bathing them in its beautiful, sanctifying grace. Right, as it is, as it is, as it is, as it is. So, okay, and you just, you know, you move on, you keep going, and nothing, you're still right in your practice, you see. If the ET shows up in front of you right now, you do the same thing, oh, okay, same practice. This place right here, this ET, this place right here, this person, this ET in this place, along with every other being and every other place in the entire universe, as it is totally bathed in God's lovely, beautiful, living light of non-special remembrance, of God's remembrance of non-specialness. Ah, wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. See? That's it. Non-specialness. Vision of non-specialness. So, do it wherever you're at. Do it wherever you're at. Don't think that you're some super special person. Oh, I'm being called away to some remote island where only the very toppermost get to go, etc. To be able to do advanced practice. No, this is advanced practice. It is the practice. Is aiming, aligning or valuing with non-specialists, the vision of non-specialists. That is the practice. We already have it. And of course, our specialist says, oh, but if I go to that island, I'll meet someone special. I'll have a special teacher, special place, meet special people. It'll be a very special situation and unique. And that's our continuity fear. That's our projections and the continuity fear associated with our projections, pulling us along about what they want to do, what they think is good for us. That's called the ego. The ego has an idea what's good for us. It's very much mistaken about that. Go with the Holy Spirit. Go with the Holy Spirit. Now, how the future works out, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. What's important is to stay centered in your practice. That's what's important. People will be some teachers, genuine teachers will be some places, right? You know, theoretically, you know, someone could say, oh, there's the teacher, you go there, or something like that. All of that's possible. Teachers have a location, though. So, you know, you could say something, oh, you get to go see them at this location or something. But what's important is to remain centered in your practice and recognize how simple, how easy it is. And as you practice, you are your own teacher. The inner teacher is in charge. The inner teacher is more important than the outer teacher. The inner teacher is in charge, and it's in practice. Right now, as it is. Right now, right here. Right here, right now. I dwell. Past, present, and future universe of total non-specialness. A past, a present, and a future universe of total non-specialness. Right now, as it is. Vision of oneness, vision of oneness, vision of oneness. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And so you take your practice with you wherever you go. So it's going to be a wild ride coming up for sure. So heads up on that. Whether Monsieur Julien is correct or not. Contact has been worked on for a long time. And when you get, you know, the Vatican also has been talking also about extraterrestrials. So what if extraterrestrials showed up on this planet? How they tell the parishioners, hey, you know, the communicants, hey, what if ET show up? And you know, what should be your response? And they tell us, well, you should, you know, be loving and accepting, and you know, and they're preparing you. And the President Clinton saying, hey, you know, he's right, saying everybody, don't be surprised if they show up, could bring global peace, you know, of course, and all this kind of stuff. So they're putting a very positive spin. All these top spin doctors have been working to put a positive spin on the ET showing up. So you know, it's going to happen sooner or later. It could happen tomorrow, as a matter of fact, or not. But it's going to happen. So we have to already be ahead of the game. And it's just yesterday's news. It has no importance. That's how I feel. It's like a non-story, non-event. We're already way past that. Way past that. We're way past anybody from any place showing up here. We're past anybody from the future showing up here. We're past anybody from the past showing up here. We're past all that. Way, way past that. We have continuity practice. We understand what's valuable. So when you understand what's valuable, you're past everything that's not valuable, automatically. You know, you're looking at the gold, they're looking at the garbage. You know, they're gonna spend a million years talking to other people about garbage. Oh, look at that piece of garbage. Isn't that interesting piece of garbage? Yeah. Oh, wow, let's explore this part of the garbage dump. And you're looking at the gold for a little while, and then you are even beyond looking. You're knowing the gold, as it were. You're knowing the living light. You're knowing it. You are the living light. So, you know, that's a huge difference. Don't be fixated on appearances, either from the past, the present, or the future. Or from this place or some other place in space, from out there or over there, or from this galaxy or this star system or this planet, doesn't matter. If somebody flies in from, I mean, we live here in the Bay Area, people flying in from all over the world constantly, just constant people go to the airport. Who cares? If somebody, well, you don't want to be them flying, you don't want somebody flying in from, was it Guinea right now? With Ebola, that is for sure. but you just say, who cares whether they just flew in from Senegal or China, Argentina, Canada, Vietnam, who cares where they come from whatever part of the globe, it doesn't matter. How does that affect your vision of non-specialness? It doesn't affect in any way, right? So it doesn't matter where people come from or where they're going. Coming or going doesn't matter. There is no specialness to any of it. There is no specialness to any coming or going. This moment as it is totally specialness free. There is no specialness to coming or going, arriving or departing. From the past, arriving from the past, arriving from the future, arriving from Sirius. Arriving from Orion, arriving, coming up from under the earth, giants coming up from under the earth, None of that matters where they come from. None of it matters where they're going. Totally non-special. And our only goal is the vision of oneness. We don't care about interacting with its comings and goings and drawing conclusions. There's nothing, no conclusion to draw from them. We only want to view the vision of oneness, vision of non-specialness. That reminds us of our home. We say, ah, that's the only use that this universe has for, is to remind us of our home by seeing a total vision of total non-specialness. That's the only use it'll ever have. That's the only value we'll ever have. And we can see that value right now, right here where we are, sitting where we are. We can realize that value right now, because it's already the case. The Holy Spirit, which is the voice, the presence of our unprojected will, has the vision of oneness for us in our mind already. It's already there. It's already there. It was concurrent with our desire to replace God. Concurrent with that was the vision of oneness in the Holy Spirit. Same time. Same happened at the same instant. So no time passed, no continuity problem, no identity problem ever occurred. Vision of oneness has always been within our mind. The Holy Spirit's always been within our mind. And it's there right now. So there's never been anything special ever happen in the universe. Never been, never will be anything special happen. How could there be anything special to everywhereness? Something from outside came in? Oh my God, something very special happened. Someone just arrived from outside of everywhereness. We've got to commemorate this. We have to commemorate this. This is a historic occasion. This changes everything. No. No possibility of that. There's nothing outside of our mind. There's nothing outside of our mind. There's nothing outside of our will. There is no outside to it. There's no inside to it. There's only is just the one totality, the holiness of it, is all there is, the holiness of it. So we are ready to embark upon a rocky road as far as the world goes, because the people will be transfixed, enamored of ETs. They'll either violently reject them or worship them like idols or something. You know, our reaction is no reaction. You think, imagine Longchenpa, no reaction. Someone arises at his monastery in Tibet. Welcome. The blessings of non-specialness be upon you and everyone here and everyone in the entire universe. Please sit down, have some tea, and let us practice. No specialness. Just keep practicing. When you think there's something special, you're going to pursue that. You're going to think, I need to pursue it. Because I think there's a way that I can deal with the continuity problem by not dealing with it. That's what the world believes. Oh, we don't need to deal with the continuity problem. We can make this world a paradise. We don't need to go back home. We don't need to be reminded of home. Let's make this world our home. Let's make it our home. Let's make experiences our home. Let's make the temporary rising and subsiding appearances. Let's say that's our home. Something, a self, is dwelling in these appearances. They are, no, nonsense. Never can make it our home. It's a waste of time. So, just recognize the vision of total non-specialness is here now. It's here now. It's here now. It's always here now. It's always here now. And that's actual love, that's real love, the vision of total non-specialness. Not that somebody's lovely, these people are lovely, no. Total non-specialness, everything, every place, everything, every thought, every emotion, everything in the mind is imagining, the totality of the projection is equally lovely, bathed in God's lovely light of, living light of remembrance. That's love, that's love, that's when you feel the real love. You say, I love this. You see, you love it. We love it because it's true. It's true. And we feel at home. We feel at ease. We feel like, ah, this is what I am. This is my home. I feel this is perfect for me. So we love it. So, don't know how things will go in the future. In my life, I certainly don't know how things are going. At a definite crisis point, huge crisis point. But again, I think the world's at a huge crisis point. By the way, April 4th, 2014, fourth month, fourth day in 2014, 44th president is in the United States. A lot of fours are lining up. Fourth dimension could be the time the fourth dimension says, hey, there's something special in the fourth dimension for you folks. You don't have to do your spiritual exercises. You don't have to worry about God. We've got the whole fourth dimensional thing for you. That'll delay you for, you know, oh, tens and tens and thousands of years. So, you know, we got this great specialness for you. Come on, take it. You know, it's now on sale here. It's a blue light special on sale. And yeah, on April, it wouldn't be surprising at all if it came about on April 4th. They're very into numbers, and four is one of their key numbers. But again, there's nothing special. Right now, I am dwelling in the past, present, and future non-special universe. And may that dawn upon all of us very, very soon. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for watching. That's it.